The most annoying thing while setting up a custom firmware on your 3DS is you cannot open the Rosalina menu to open FBI. I'm sure some of you had this problem, and I will show you a simple trick to fix this. So, let's get started. So, before doing anything, let's inspect the console to get some information. Go back to the home screen. The first thing to do is to check the console's buttons. Press the bumper buttons to see if they are working well. Now, open the internet browser. Press the select button to test it out. You can also try pressing the start button. Then you can quit the internet browser. Now press the D-pad down button and make sure it is working fine. We can see that the L, D-pad down, and select buttons work normally. You should be able to open the Rosalina menu. If you find any broken buttons, then you must repair it. Continue watching this guide for now. The next thing is not crucial, but we can check the firmware prefix inside the system settings. When it says work, then your console could be running stock firmware or maybe custom firmware, as it is not a definitive indicator. We should dig some more information about this console. Close the system settings. And turn off the console. Now we will find out if the console has custom firmware. Press and hold the select button, then press the power button. If your console has custom firmware, then you should see the Lupa 3DS configuration screen. But if your console goes directly to the home screen, then you must first hack your console. Use my video guide or go to 3ds.hacks.guide. If you have Lupa 3DS version 8.0 or newer, then you should be able to open the Rosalina menu. If you have version 7.1, then you need to go to 3ds.hacks.guide and do the updating B9S guide. If you have version 7.0.5 or older, then you need to follow the A9LH to B9S guide from the same site. See the link in the description below. And if you haven't selected any option in this screen, then you need to move the cursor down to Show NAND or User String in System Settings, then press A to select it. Then press Start to boot the console. It is not related to the Rosalina menu, but it is better to do this step. And when you go to the system settings, now you can see that there is a sys prefix in front of the firmware version. Please note that it is only an indicator as it is not directly related to the Rosalina menu. You can try opening the download play and press the combo keys of L, D-pad down, and select button. Normally, you should be able to open the Rosalina menu, but if you still cannot open it, then we can try another way. If you can open the Rosalina menu, then continue to the finalizing step on the 3ds.hacks.guide. See the link in the description below. If your console has broken buttons and you cannot open the Rosalina menu, then you can try replacing the config.bin file of the Lupa 3DS custom firmware. Turn off the console for now. Remove the microSD card or the standard SD card from the console. Download the Lupa 3DS config archive from the link in the description. Download WinRAR or Xeon-ZIP to extract the downloaded archive. This is your console's SD card content. Yours might be different than mine. Open the Lupa 3DS config archive and enter the folder inside it. I made two combo keys options to open the Rosalina menu. You can choose whatever you like. Now enter the Lupa folder on your SD card and replace the config.bin file with the one from the archive. Reinsert the SD card to the console. Turn it on and open the download play. I selected the D-pad right and A option to open the Rosalina menu. So if you choose the other option, then press the chosen combo keys. You should be able to open the Rosalina menu, but if you still cannot open it, then we should do it traditionally. And again, if you can open the Rosalina menu, then open the finalizing step on the 3ds.hex.guide. See the link in the description below. Suppose if you still cannot open the Rosalina menu after checking and passing every previous step, then we need to use the traditional way, which is injecting the FBI to health and safety app. Turn off the console for now. Remove the micro SD card or the standard SD card from the console. Download the 3DS Starter Pack from the link in the description. Double-click the Starter Pack archive and extract all its content into the SD card. Well, actually, you only need the CIS folder. But to update the apps and Luma 3DS on your console, then it is better to extract them all. Oh, by the way, replace all the existing files and folders. Reinsert the SD card into the console. Press and hold the start button, then press the power button to open God Mode 9. If you are prompted about creating an essential files backup, then do it. And if you are prompted to fix the RTC, then set it to your current time and date. Press the home button, then select scripts. Select GM9 Mega Script. Now select FBI to HNS option. Select inject FBI to HNS. Then press A to confirm it. Now select the FBI.cia file. It's inside the CIS folder. Press A to confirm it. Then press A again to unlock the system. Input the given combo keys. Press A to continue. Press B to cancel, then select exit. Press A to relock the NAND. Then press start to reboot the console. Now you can open the health and safety app to run FBI. It is permanent until you restore it. At this step, you need to continue to section 4 of the finalizing setup. See the link in the description below. And after that, you can go back to section 3.12 under 13, then quit the homebrew launcher. Now we will restore the health and safety app to its original function. Turn off the console for now. Reopen the God Mode 9 by pressing and holding the start button, then press the power button. Now reverse what we did earlier by pressing the home button, then choose script. Select GM9 Mega Script and choose FBI to HNS options. This time select restore HNS. Then press A to confirm it. And press A again to unlock the NAND. Input the given combo keys. Press A to continue, then press B to cancel it. And select exit. And press A to relock the NAND. And finally, you can press the start button to reboot the console. And there you go, you have completed the guide on how to fix the not showing Rosalina menu after you hack the console. I hope it helped you. Thanks for watching and see you guys later.